Hello everybody, welcome back for another video. Hope you're all doing well and that you're all having a great day. We have another question. I already told you before, I love doing these things. I have to use my tablet once again. It's a bit of a long question. As always, if you have any questions at all about anything pertaining to finance, art, life, I guess, even sometimes as well, don't be afraid to ask me. I do love answering all of these questions. Today's question is, someone said, I'm extremely curious and would love if you could bring this up on your TMI channel or this one as to whether you invest in NFT art. I'll get into that in 1 second so you understand exactly what that is. Since it is such that you are an avid art collector, it seems like the perfect middle ground for you, crypto and art. But I have a feeling you're going to flat out say, no, I do not. Perhaps you have already addressed this and I missed it in that episode. Thank you for your question. I have not addressed this. I have gotten this question a lot across both channels and I'm a bit, not embarrassed, but I feel like I should have covered it already. For those of you who do not know, the words NFT stand for non-fungible token. What that means is basically, it's basically art that's on a blockchain, similar to Bitcoin, but not Bitcoin. These are tokens or pieces of art on top of a blockchain that are completely identifiable apart from each other. I.e., normally, the idea when it comes to cryptocurrencies is that when using the blockchain, it's not always so. The coins are always kind of look the same. I made a video on this as well. I'm not going to go too in-depth about it right now. With NFT, non-fungible tokens, you can tell immediately that this token is for this piece of art and this token is for this piece of art. There's no confusion at all. It looks exactly like this art and the other token looks exactly like this art. The idea is that the NFT, non-fungible token space, so kind of the same exact way you can tell, imagine you're trying to sell a piece of art. You can't confuse this with this. They look completely different. The same exact way, this is how the tokens will be. The art market is already absolutely insane. Continues to grow all the time. I think the normal estimate for art per year increases around 19% in value as like a low range figure. If you have a remarkable, absolutely wonderful, amazing piece of art, it's going to multiply several percentage points higher, especially as the years end up going on. The interesting part is, it appears as though there is a trend of people, trend in the market, moving towards digital art. We have had digital art since around the 1960s, 1970s. It was mainly people recording with like the really big clunky camcorders and putting it on TV or having like lights and stuff shine around the room. This was the form of digital art that we had before. The new form of digital art is, do you know the artist Kaws? K-A-W-S. He has like an app where you can like actually look around with the app and you can see like a digital man, balloon character thing floating around in the sky around you. This is kind of the digital art that people are talking about. The idea is to finally get to it. I had to explain a little bit before, is that non-fungible token art, blockchain art is going to become the thing for the future as it is such a new untapped market. A lot of people believe that getting into this market right now will be quite beneficial to your wallet sometime in the future. No one knows this for certain. Don't go out there and start buying blockchain digital art, but there are a lot of people within the cryptocurrency space. I think the name that you'll constantly find popping around is this guy named Pompliano, P-O-M-P-L-I-A-N-O. I think I spelled that correctly. He's been in the news a lot because he mentioned before, just a couple of weeks ago from the time of me making this video, that he's been buying tons of NFT digital art as he expects the art market, the digital art market, to completely go completely insane. So you get into the discussion of if normal art, which is already hugely tapped into market, goes up by 19% roughly per year, what kind of percentages can you then expect on the digital token asset art kind of front? Cover that. It kind of also ties into the other topic, and I know this is going to sound pretty weird for people who are not used to this topic. The idea of digital land is also something that many people are expecting is going to go completely insane over the next couple of years. The idea being, in future video games, you will be able to buy land inside of that game. Imagine like being able to buy a fraction of the World of Warcraft. Like you own this entire street. This idea is picking up quite rapidly within the cryptocurrency and the blockchain space, and people are buying digital land all the time. And similar to that, people believe that much like 10 years ago, no one could have considered a digital asset. Like imagine in 2008, if someone said, hey, do you want to buy a number on the screen? You'd be like, please get out of my face. You're clearly on something. Because now it makes sense to us 12 years later that Bitcoin, just a number on the screen, is a digital asset. The same exact way, in the future, people are expected to understand that digital art, digital land also has value. Same exact way for digital art. I know it sounds completely abstract, but I've been in this space for a long time and it does now finally make sense to me. You kind of have to really repeat it over and over and over. So these are apparently going to be the new future trends. To answer the other part of your question, I'm actually 100% looking into buying digital art. Part of the problem is I know the physical art world pretty okay. I may not be a master, but I know which artists to kind of look for, to go to, what pieces to look for, what is expected to raise in value, how to evaluate the pricing of things to see if something is undervalued, overvalued, if I'm making a really good deal as I'm buying it, et cetera, et cetera. For the digital art world, I don't know that much because it's all completely brand new. This has been a thing for about a year and a half. There are a couple of websites. I won't say any of them out loud because I don't want to funnel people to one particular website. There are about six of them right now that are relatively popular. And when we get the news on my other channel about the actual, not usage of these websites, the amount of money that these websites have made over the course of the last year and a half, I think it's roughly around like, I think it's over $1 billion at this point, if I'm not mistaken. But the issue is that a lot of these people are brand new artists. So you are either buying up everything in an effort to kind of, if this 10% becomes popular, well, I have what they have. But the issue is you can't just simply throw money into the market and hope to kind of hit something who's going to be really popular and really big for you to be able to make money on. So I'm still doing research on it. I promise you, I'm going to at some point buy digital art. If I can figure out in any way which artists are big, especially if there are artists who are already relatively popular, who are releasing digital art, I will make a video on it. I promise you. I made a video before on the other artists who I collect. I will do the exact same thing. And at some point, I'll figure out a way, I don't know how, to show you what digital art that I own. I'm a little afraid because I'm an obsessive collector. I mentioned this before in other videos. I have multiple copies of everything, nearly everything that I own, unless it's like a really big piece. Some pieces have cost a lot and you can't really buy multiples of them. But everything else, I have a lot of. So if I figure out that there's an artist who has a piece of work for 85 whatever, and an edition of 300 and it's digital, I'm probably gonna buy a lot of them, which is really, I mean, it's fine, it's an investment, but I can't help myself when it comes to doing these things. Yeah, and I even said the last part, I have to look more. I have to see exactly where this is all going. Because regardless of the hype that there might be right now for digital art, I don't know what the market is going to look like in 5 years. I may allocate 15,000 at some point into the digital art market to simply be like, okay, I'll buy these and see exactly where it goes. Same exact thing for digital land. I'm pretty sure I'm also going to buy digital land as well because it just sounds completely insane in my mind to not, like, what is digital land? Like, you have to at least dabble in it a little tiny bit. The digital art marketplace is expected to be extremely huge, gigantic. They're already making tons of sales on these websites. A lot of the art is actually pretty cool as well. Like, it's not just like this, but digital. It's like, you might have seen on Instagram or a couple of other places where there's some people who make art. There was one, it was like a rubber face. And out of the mouth comes like a ball. And then the ball explodes, but then there's like another digital face inside of it. It's like kind of like this continual pattern that kind of keeps on going. I don't know if I explained that correctly or properly, but there's some, you know, MC Escher, like the people with all the staircases and everything is kind of all over the place and you can't really tell what's what. People have made art of that, digital art, where it's like someone like actually walking through it and going through a lot of his paintings that he's done. So it's actually pretty cool. It's just a matter of, I am not currently mentally in a space to throw thousands of dollars at something that I just simply don't completely understand, but you'd better believe I'm going to be getting into digital art and I'm gonna do it with a vengeance, which doesn't make any sense, but you understand exactly what I'm talking about. I do hope you all enjoyed. I do hope you all are having a great day, a great morning, a great afternoon, a great evening, wherever you are, wherever you might be. I do hope that it is absolutely fantastic. If you have any more questions, ask away. I love all of them. Thank you all once again for watching and or listening. And I will most certainly be talking to you all soon. See you.